keeper of the holy gates in the glorious kingdom of God. All who wish to enter heaven must first present themselves to me, so that I may enter their names into the holy register. Now, you're probably wondering why I'm here instead of there attending my duties. Well, every 100 years or so, when I get a day off, there's nothing I enjoy more than selecting a favorite story from my vast celestial records and flying down to Earth to tell it to a group of potential angels. Most of you fit into that category, with a few exceptions, but time can work miracles. Now, before I begin, let me just say this. Once I've started, I don't like being interrupted. So let's please take out our cell phones at this time and turn them to the off position. That goes for beepers and pagers, and any small children you may have with you. Also, it is important that you don't use cameras with flash attachments. Unexpected flashes of light can be distracting and dangerous for those of us up here. Talk about a fall from grace. Now, the story I've chosen for you today concerns a most miserable, thoroughly unhappy, and utterly dejected cherub who was known throughout heaven as the Littlest Angel. He was exactly 8 years, 4 months, 5 days, 7 hours, and 42 minutes of age when he found himself standing before me at the gates of heaven. But the story begins before that, in a little town called Bethlehem, where Michael, that was his name, Michael, where Michael lived with his mother and sister and tended sheep with his friends.
Come on, Michael, I tagged you for the square. Same square, Michael, you had to fall down and really tag. Those are the old rules. I agree that we have new rules. And the new rules say, when you become tagged, you become king of the heavens and live forever. You're not a king.
You're always making up rules. Why can't you just play like everybody else?
Because I'm not everybody else. I'm me. That's special. Tell them I'm special, Mother. Tell them what you said.
I did say that, Michael. But what else did I say?
That everybody is special. Even him?
Everyone is special and has their own special song to sing.
Sing a song.
Thank you.
yes, I've been expecting you, little fellow. Here, you see, I shall write your name in the great book and...
Achoo!
My word, that infernal sneeze made me blot the page. That is something I have never done before in all eternity. Your handkerchief, where's your handkerchief?
I left it at home, sir.
Here, take mine then. And stand up straight and straighten your halo. Try to conduct yourself with more dignity in the future. It's a great honor to be accepted into God's heavenly kingdom.
Sir, yes, sir!
What? Oh, don't listen to me. I got up on the wrong side of the cloud this morning. Are you ready to make your way through the pearly gates?
For real?
Right this way. Heaven is a wonderful place. Everybody loves it here.
Come along, Anaheim. Don't go. We don't want to be late.
I don't see what difference it makes, Angelica. Not going anywhere.
Now, that's no way for a newly appointed guardian angel to talk. Your first job. Aren't you excited?
Well, maybe. I can't spend eternity with him. Does he keep having talent at all?
Well, we'll just have to find out. But no matter what, Anaheim, it's your job to help him get in.
Oh, brother.
Welcome to heaven, Michael. We gotta clean you up, child, and give you some on-the-job training. Oh, yeah. Now listen up. You've got a lot to learn, because if you don't learn, you don't lie. But if you're smart and always use your head, you'll be right at home. Just pick your talent, easy, 1, 2, 3. If you got talent, child, I guarantee
you're gonna see how the best survive.
We making odds
out of staying alive. If you do just as you're told, these are streets of gold.
Follow their instructions and you'll be feeling at home in no time.
Bye.
Michael, we think...
And so she thinks...
that you need to start your journey of self-discovery by becoming a little more... centered.
What? It's some sort of new age mumbo-jumbo. That's what I started getting into lately, but back in my day.
Back in your day?
What's wrong about that?
Can't be back in your day. Your day hasn't even happened yet.
Then why am I here?
In heaven, all time is now, and every day is then.
Mumbo-jumbo.
It's not mumbo-jumbo, Anaham. It's meditation. And Gouda is an excellent teacher.
I hear your call. Someone is seeking wisdom?
That must be me, Mr.
It's called meditation, my dear child, and it is a wonderful thing. Just watch and learn.
Yowza!
perhaps our young friend should seek a different path to enlightenment. Perhaps you should start him on fly lessons. That should use up some of his youthful energy.
An excellent idea. Come, take Michael to the flat school.
And where are you going?
I have a 2 o'clock quarterly. Michelangelo is giving us a sneak peek at his new ceiling.
Okay, kid, I guess it's ready. I'll be going to Wobbly Under.
That's it, Liza. You got it. Now make a look to the left. Steady, steady. Watch out for that asteroid.
Hey, Skylar, I got a new student for you. This is Michael.
Excellent. Elijah's up there right now. He's doing splendidly.
Yo, Elijah! Good work, buddy!
Anaheim, he's flying! He's really flying!
Well, duh! How do you think we could get from cloud to cloud?
Come on up, Michael. You'll be a loop-de-looping in no time.
Go on!
I don't know about this.
Thank you! Thank you! It was nothing.
You hear that, Michael? It just looks hard.
Go on! It's really fun!
Look at him. He doesn't even look like an angel. His halo is terribly charmed.
Can't boss I do.
Do it, Michael. Once you've flown, you get the extra angel cake and supper.
Now close your eyes and think heavenly, peaceful thoughts.
I can't! It isn't going to happen! I just can't!
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 He said the C word.
Michael, there is no such thing as can't in heaven. Come on, about it, class.
Next time you're found with your chin on the ground, there's a lot to be learned. So look around.
Just what makes that little old ant think he'll move that rubber tree plant? Anyone knows an ant can't move a rubber tree plant.
But he's got high hopes. He's got
Go, Michael!
This
Buenos dias. Hello. What do you mean?
Just that's all.
Yes, yes. What do you do?
Nothing.
Por qué no? Why not?
There's nothing for me to do here. I'm not an angel. I'm a boy. Everyone feels like an angel. I can't meditate, I can't fight, and I can't sing. I tried. I don't belong here.
Well,
it never rains here. Everybody knows it rains to make you grow. And you know what you need here? Grass from there to bloom and trees to climb. I'm used.
Where is your home, Michael?
Way down there someplace. It must be smaller than I thought. You can't even see it.
Well, I'd like to see it.
Really?
Very much.
But you can.
Well, I could if you describe it to me.
Okay, well, it's just a house. That's a nice one. It's got a slanty roof with a big chimney with smoke coming out all the time.
Siempre? All the time?
Uh-huh. And that's what keeps it so warm on my bed is. And underneath my bed, I have a box. I keep lots of things in it. You should see.
I used to have a box like that a long time ago. So long ago, I can hardly remember. What else is in your house?
Well, my mother's kitchen room is neat. My mother's a good cook.
Is she? También la mía. So is mine.
She was?
Oh, very good. She used to make us.
My mother makes bread.
Brown bread?
Uh-huh.
Oy.
What's the matter?
Oh, I love brown bread.
I miss mom. I miss my mom.
I know you do, Michael. But I'm sure she's thinking of you. Right now. Thank you. Are you sure? Is this right?
Oh, I see it's perfect. I think it's exactly right.
If you say so.
Niño precioso, más que el niño, risueño niño, Dios del amor.
Angels on their way, they fill their eyes.
Bethlehem of Judea. And as the glorious tidings spread through paradise, all the angels rejoiced, and their voices were lifted to herald the miracle of miracles, the coming of the Christ child. The angels and archangels, the seraphim and cherubim, the wingmakers, the halosmith, yes, even gatekeeper David, put aside their usual tasks to prepare their gifts for the blessed infant. All but the littlest angel. He sat himself down on the topmost step of the golden stairs and anxiously waited for his parade.
These are the things my son too will know and love and cherish. I accept this gift in the name of the child of Jesus, born and buried this night in Bethlehem.
things into the Holy Register. Now, you're probably wondering why I'm here instead of there attending to my duties. Well, every 100 years or so, when I have a day off, there's nothing I enjoy more than selecting a favorite story from my vast celestial records and flying down to Earth to tell it to a group of potential angels. Most of you fit into that category, with a few exceptions. But time can work miracles. Now, before I begin, let me just say this. Once I've started, I don't like being interrupted. So if you have any cell phones, please take them out now and turn them to the off position. That goes for beepers, pagers, and any small children you may have with you. Also, it is very important that if you use cameras, don't use cameras with flash devices. Sudden flashes of light can be distracting for those of us up here and very dangerous. Talk about a fall from grace. Now, you're probably wondering why I would come to El Paso when I only get to come down to Earth every 100 years or so. Well, this is a very important place. It's a peaceful place. It means the difference in peace and war between two nations. Anybody know why Chamizal National Memorial is here? Why are we here? Why is it here? Yes?
Because the Americans and the Mexicans fought over this land, and they agreed after a long time that the Americans would own it.
Well, you're really close. For 100 years, the Mexicans and Americans disputed the land that we're on right now. And the river kept changing its course, so the boundaries kept changing. And finally, in 1963, they came up with the Chamizal Treaty, right? And there's where the Americans and the Mexicans made an agreement that there would be a set boundary, and they actually built the river with concrete so that it wouldn't change anymore, right? And so this memorial is a peaceful memorial, celebrating the peaceful solution to a 100-year dispute and coming up with this park. So now let's get on with our real story here. The story I've chosen for you today concerns a most miserable, thoroughly unhappy, and utterly dejected cherub who was known throughout heaven as the Littlest Angel. He was exactly 8 years, 4 months, 5 days, 7 hours, and 42 minutes of age when he found himself standing before me at the gates of heaven. But the story begins before that, in a little town called Bethlehem, where Michael, that was his name, Michael, where Michael and his family, Michael, his mother, and his sister, lived together, and he tended sheep with his friends.
Come on, Michael, I tagged you fair and square.
Be clear, Michael, you have to fall down when you're tagged.
Those are the old rules. I agree that we have new rules. And you will say, when you're tagged, you can keep on the head.
I did say that, Michael. But what else did I say?
That everybody is special. Even him?
Everyone is special. And has their own special song to sing.
Became very sick. His mother stayed by his side all through the night, going over the treasures that he kept in a beautiful box she had made for him.
That's just a toy?
And what about this rock? What story is behind it?
Not a rock, Mother. Can't you see? A diamond. One of the biggest diamonds in the world. It had been here high up on the mountain. It had been there for 100 years. So I and my army quest.
Your army? Made me block a page. Something I have never done before in all eternity. Your handkerchief? Where is your handkerchief?
Left at home, sir.
Here it is. Take mine. Stand up straight. Straighten your halo. Try to conduct yourself with a bit more dignity. It's a great honor to be accepted into God's heavenly kingdom.
Sir, yes, sir.
What? Don't listen to me. I got up on the wrong side of the cloud this morning. Are you ready to make your way through the pearly gates?
For real?
Absolutely. Right this way. Heaven is a wonderful place. Everybody loves it here.
Don't, Donald. We don't want to be late.
I don't see what difference it makes, Donald. He's not going anywhere.
Now that's no way for a newly appointed guardian angel to talk. Your first job. Aren't you excited?
Well, maybe. But I can't spend any journeys with him. Does the kid have any talent at all?
Well, just have to find out, Anaheim. But no matter what, it's your job to help him fit in.
Thank you.
Ladies, let us seek our chakras over our cloud nine. Perhaps our young friend should seek a different path to enlightenment. Start him on flying lessons. That should use up some of his youthful energy.
An excellent idea. Anaheim, take Matt to the flat school.
Where are you going?
I have a 2 o'clock tour to leave. Michelangelo has given us a sneak peek at his new ceiling.
Okay, kid, I guess it's your beat. Off we go to the wild blue yonder.
That's it, Lyra. You got it. Now bang your room to the left. Steady, steady. Watch out for that earth door.
Hey, Skylar, I got this student for you. This is Michael.
Excellent. Elijah's up there right now. He's doing splendidly.
Yo, Elijah. Good work, buddy.
Anaheim, he's flying. He's really flying.
Well, duh. How do you think we could get from cloud to cloud?
Come on up, Michael. You'll be looped and limping in no time.
Go on.
I don't know about this.
It was nothing.
You hear that, Michael? It just looks hard.
Go on. It's really fun. Look at him. He doesn't even look like an angel.
His halo is terribly tarnished.
And lopsided.
Do it, Michael. Once you've flown, you'll get an extra angel cake at supper.
Now close your eyes and think heavenly, peaceful thoughts.
I can't! This isn't going to happen! I just can't!
Can't!
He said the C word.
Michael, there is no such thing as can't in heaven. Tell them all about it, class. Little old ram, but
time.
I accept this gift in the name of the child of Jesus, born of Mary.
My son is gone. He's not with us anymore.
Our children will never really leave us, even when they have to go away.
Sometimes I think I can feel him near me, but I know that's only a dream.
Mother, look!